In just a moment, I'm about to show you a new and better way to manage your KNX projects. Before I do that though, we have to talk about the current state of KNX project management. Of course, we all love KNX for its stability and longevity, but let me ask you a couple of questions. Do you ever have trouble knowing what's actually going on in your KNX projects? Do you lack insights into what actually happens once your clients start using their smart home? Or are you left in the dark? And wouldn't it be great if you would know about issues and problems in a project before a client even notices? Based on these insights, you could make swift decisions and improvements, and the client wouldn't even know that something went wrong. We're solving this and much more with the new One Home System Manager. While the One Home Server KNX Pro is a device that does it all, One Home System Manager is tailored specifically to your needs as an integrator. This device is a purpose-built solution for KNX integrators who want a better way to manage their KNX projects, who want a clearer way of identifying and troubleshooting potential issues, and who want to offer their clients responsive remote support. This means that System Manager is a KNX IP interface. It includes a refreshed and improved secure remote ETS programming for reliable ETS programming from anywhere in the world. It includes an advanced traffic monitor. This means you can always know what's happening in your system in real time, or you can also check history. You can also create custom graphs to help you have a clear visual overview of your system data. There's also improved One Home automations that now support Lua scripting, so you can handle many more customer requests. And there's also two bonus tools coming in the near future. The first being automatic KNX health checks. This will help you make sure that all of your devices, actuators, sensors, Modbus devices, or other devices connected to KNX are always working as intended. And the second of those tools is advanced email alerting. This will ensure that you as the integrator will always be the first one to know about potential issues, and it will also help you to address these issues before the client even notices. Let's now take a quick look into each of these tools and how you can incorporate them into your workflow. Of course, you can program your KNX project locally using the built-in KNX IP interface, but with the launch of One Home System Manager, we will also be releasing a refreshed and improved version of Secure Remote ETS programming. This version has been optimized for stable operation anywhere in the world, Asia, Middle East, Australia, but it also works in areas where internet connectivity might not be the best. What this means is that once you have System Manager integrated into your project, you can access and program your KNX project from anywhere. No more running to the project site just to fix something. Just open your laptop, connect to System Manager, and take your ETS programming from there. This is also a good time to mention that you can manage all of your project in a single spot, that is remote.onehome.io. Here you can manage your projects, invite co-workers or employees, and also assign them to projects. Now let's jump into the One Home dashboard and take a look at the next tool that you have in your KNX management tool belt. On the left side, under the new section called Insights, you have the traffic monitor. Click on it, and you get two options to monitor your traffic. The first is KNX Monitor, which is of course focused specifically on what's happening in your KNX system, but you can also view what's happening with your system as a whole with the System Monitor. So if we take a look first at the KNX Monitor, we click on Live Monitor, and as we see, the KNX traffic is already flowing through, and we can check exactly what's happened when, which group address has been sent in the KNX system, what's the linked device, so we have a clear overview over what's happening. If we want to test something in our KNX system, we can also do so quickly with this send KNX telegram function here on the right. With these, we can read or write group addresses in our KNX system. We have also more ways to adapt how we monitor our traffic. If we go here under filters, we can, for example, add a specific device that we want to take a look at, or a group address that we want to take a look at. We can also use the search function to select a specific device or group address. So here you can add a device to filter by device or by group address, or you can also use this free search to browse through your data. Okay, so this has been a live KNX monitor, but we can also see what has happened in the past. What's the history of our KNX traffic? So if we switch into history, we can see exactly what has happened. We can also here select a specific time range in which we want to monitor our history. And we can also, as before, filter by devices, filter by group addresses, or use this free search. So when a client reaches out and asks, why did something happen with lights yesterday at 5 p.m., you can always go check in the history and have a confident answer for your client. Now let's take a look at the system monitor. So KNX monitor is of course KNX specific, but system monitor also takes into account all other changes that happened in your One Home system. So let's check out the system monitor. As we can see, the traffic is coming in, and here the difference is that of course we see actual changes to devices as opposed to KNX telegrams. We can also show KNX traffic also in the system monitor with this toggle here. Then we have a big overview over everything. But another cool thing is that we can show change requests in the system monitor. So for example, as we see here, here's a one change request, and we see that it's coming from an automation. So why is this so useful? Let's take an example. A client reaches out and they ask you, why are shades going down at a certain time of the day? I don't understand. You can go into the system monitor, show change requests, and you can quickly see that a certain device change has happened because of a certain automation. This way, you can confidently say to your client what is happening and also make informed decisions or improvements to a specific automation so that such things don't happen anymore. And of course, similarly to the KNX monitor, we have available filters to make your search easier. You can filter by devices, use the free search. If you have show KNX traffic enabled, you can also filter by group addresses. And of course, if you switch to history, you can see your system monitor history as a whole with the change requests, with the KNX traffic, everything in one spot. With the traffic monitor, you will always be able to confidently explain to your clients what happened, why that happened, and it will also be easier for you to identify and resolve issues. The next thing we're gonna look at is graphs. Graphs can really help you get a clear visual overview over all your data in the system. So if we go here to graphs, let's go to the entrance room, and we're immediately presented with some pre-made graphs. If you have devices such as temperature sensors, humidity sensors, light sensors in your rooms, there are some graphs that will already be pre-made for you, so you can have a good starting point. So if we see here in the entrance, we already have temperature, humidity, brightness, and also a contact sensor. But you can also create custom graphs on your own. If we go to the dining room, here we can see that we already made a CO2 sensor custom graph. For this graph, we used a group address 750 that represents this CO2 sensor. And of course, you can change the timeline in which you see these graphs. So now we have last 24 hours, let's maybe increase this to last 2 days. But custom graphs is not the only thing you can customize. You can also add your own custom views. For this example, we already have an energy view created, and in it we have already created a graph that shows us energy consumption for car charging. If we expand this, we can see that we are here measuring two metrics. One is current energy draw, and the blue one is the total energy consumption. If we increase here to 7 days, we can see how exactly car charging went on. And of course, in this expanded view, we can also filter out what we want to have in this view. So if we click here on the title of this metric, it hides, comes back. This way, we really can customize the way we measure data. So now we took a look at the insights section of One Home dashboard. So traffic monitor and graphs. What's next? One Home Automations. We can all agree that KNX is powerful, but sometimes you might even need to do some custom scripting. While One Home Automations have been available for a while now, they got some major improvements in the past few months. And now with the release of System Manager, it's no different. So far, you could use One Home Automations to create advanced logic with the help of trigger, condition, action and wait blocks. And now with the release of System Manager, it's no different. We have greatly improved One Home Automations yet again, and most importantly, we added a major new feature, which is Lua scripting. Before we jump into the advanced stuff, for some of you, this might be the first time that you see One Home Automations. So let's check a sample automation so you get a feel for how automations are built in this dashboard. Let's edit this night lights automation. We click on it. This is how the editor looks. You have different blocks which you can use to create your logic. You have triggers, conditions, actions, and you can also use other blocks, such as a wait block, and as we mentioned, the new Lua scripting block. This automation is a simple one. It just controls the night light in a bathroom. How it works is you first select a trigger. So if presence changes, automation starts. Then we check for a condition. Is presence detected? Yes or no? If it's not detected, of course, we want the light to be set to off. If it is detected, we check for a condition. Is it day or is it night? If it's day, of course, we want to have the light on full power so we see what's happening. But if it's light, of course, we don't want to get flashbanged by a full power light in the middle of the night. This is why we set the percentage of this light to 10%. Of course, this automation is just a simple example. There's much more advanced things you can do with just the block editors. But if you need to handle something truly custom or truly complex, you can use Lua scripting block in One Home Automations. Here I have an example of an automation that uses a Lua script block. This example automation essentially provides weather data to your KNX system. So what it does, it has a trigger that runs every minute, and then in the Lua script, it basically makes a call to an online weather service and then sends that data to your KNX system. We have made another video that takes a deep dive into Lua scripting for you, so I invite you to check it out and get into the details how you can use Lua scripting in One Home Automations. And now, before we end this video, let's also talk about the future of System Manager. As you're already used to, here at One Home, we don't just release products, we continuously try to improve them. The same goes for System Manager. As I mentioned at the start of the video, we're already working on two more tools that will help you better manage your KNX projects. The first is Automatic KNX System Health Check, which will give you an overview over the health of all your KNX devices. This tool will also help you monitor the load on your KNX bus to prevent overload of your system, which is especially useful in big projects. And the second tool is Advanced Email Alerting. This will make sure that you are the first to know about potential issues, not the client. And with that, you will be able to react quickly and manage issues before they become a big problem. Of course, this means that if you buy a System Manager now, you will get these future upgrades included. And of course, because this is a launch, it's a special occasion, we're also offering a very attractive price for the System Manager for a short period of time. You can check it out in the link in the description. Now you might be wondering, I own a One Home Server KNX Pro. Do I also get all of these functionalities? As I said before, we always strive to upgrade our products even after their launch. And this goes for our flagship model as well. So yes, all of these tools will be available as a free upgrade in a future software update for the One Home Server KNX Pro. Now all that's left to do is for you to go to that link in the description, check out the System Manager launch offer and get one for yourself.